Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And click the bell icon for notifications so you guys don't miss a single video.
And now...
All right. Ow, cock and stuffing. Ripped my earbud out of my ear. Sorry.
Well, I didn't bother mine.
Sorry about the cock and stuffing.
Okay.
Welcome back to I'm the Dude Games. And part six of The Hidden Ones. I don't know if this is going to be the last episode or not of it, but this is part six. Of course, for these two, it's part six. Yeah.
Tahira's death sends a clear message. We must eliminate Rufio.
I swear to God, if he starts flying around like Peter Pan, I'm just going to say I called it. His octopus.
He is a master at guarding himself and cutting true fear into the heart of a people.
The leader, Rufio.
Where my lieutenants have failed, I will not. I won't set foot on that cursed peninsula of savages. But they will bow to me.
I won't go over there to make them bow to me, but they'll bow.
Somehow.
I'll just make them. With my mind.
That's what tyrants do.
I
the hidden ones are. Even my wife bows to me.
Just starts grumbling unintelligibly.
Yeah.
What are your orders, sir?
Gundam style, what?
Gundam style. You don't know how these Egyptians say it in open Gundam style.
Giggity.
Yes, to the
sinner. What is with all the flamingos just taking flight?
Of fire and blood.
We did not choose this path. It chose us.
No, you did choose this path. Don't act like you didn't. You guys chose your path of revenge, and then you realized how deep the corruption was spread, so then you chose to be assassins. You chose this path.
Oh, destiny chose this for us.
No, everything's on fire. Why is everything on fire? Okay, I thought... Okay.
This is madness! Why are they killing civilians?
Something is not right.
Yeah, everything's on fire.
No, they're just attacking civilians.
Something's not right. Yeah, everything's burning.
Well, they're attacking civilians for no reason.
There's a lot of dudes. Okay.
Husband and wife, together again, king of the castle.
Well, it's like they never really got a divorce, right? They just got separated.
Well, their assassin paths led them on different individual paths, and they knew they had to sacrifice the relationship for a little while.
Yeah.
You know.
But they're still technically they're still technically married, though.
Yeah.
Like, they didn't mutually break up. They just mutually said, all right, we'll just have our separate
ways. Right, we'll separate for a while, then we'll come back, and we'll get all freaky-deaky.
And then we'll go back to our past again, and then, like, every once a year...
Like, once a year, we'll meet up and...
Fuck. Have a good fuck all day, and then we'll be good.
Yeah.
You know I can never quit that dick, Bayek.
That's what you're getting me in the first place. Oh, yeah.
Dude, like, I love these two as a couple. They're a fucking power couple.
They really are.
They really are.
It's just like a queen and a king, for sure.
Well, for Sheezy.
Like the alpha male with the alpha female.
Run, bull! It's a fire everywhere.
It's an ox.
Ox bull.
Bull ox.
Okay, for some reason... Okay, it's chain assassination.
Okay.
All right, then. Hi.
He was just waiting for you.
Gotcha.
Gotcha.
Oh no, we're too evenly matched. He struck me the same time I struck him. What the fuck?
See what I mean? Like,
he was contra-cocking his fucking thing.
His little,
the
like,
freaking fold of his, the freaking fold of his like soldier sash. Pants. I don't know what the fuck you call this.
They're like sash.
Soldier, his sash or whatever. It's freaking. It was copter cocking.
No, it
was literally spinning around, and now it's erect. You see this shit? Is he farting out of his dick? What the fuck?
I just like how it was like frozen, and then like you looked and went down.
You know, a little light urethral queefing.
You know.
Why is this guy just in the water? He's fighting the. He's this guy's fighting the water.
Oh no! He was doing something in the back of the butthole of that person in the water.
Hey, what did I tell you, soldiers, about butt fucking the citizenry? Use lube.
Use the civilians. Don't use the civilians. Sorry.
Yeah. What did I tell you? You can do it as much as you want. No, I mean don't do it. Wait, whose side am I on here?
Exactly. I'm just a guy in a towel.
Get your head out
of
your enormous ass.
I'm just a guy in a towel.
Just
I don't
a
know
guy
what
in
I.
A towel. I don't know what I'm doing anymore.
I don't know.
Whoa. Okay, that was unnecessary.
Okay, Bayek the show
very
off.
Very unnecessary.
Bayek the show off. That should be
all of them. Bayek the bastard.
Grab, climb that jackass. Look at that jackass.
I can't ride the jackass.
Oh.
I can't ride that ass. I can't. It's impossible. Find and assassinate Rufio. This better be the end of it. I'm gonna steal his boat.
What the fuck is wrong with Bayek's hand? Just like running, he's like.
He likes doing that thing while he runs.
The fucking running like the Egyptian and shit, just making waves as I run, making waves.
Sail out to. Wait, there better not be soldiers. These are soldiers.
I like how you're just going in a circle.
Okay, so I'm actually gonna do the smart thing and dive underwater. So as not to be spotted by the soldiers on the little mini boats.
Mini boats. Mini boats. Ah! My mini boat. Ah! You scared me.
I'm just steadily losing air and setting my eagle above. Okay. How many guys are on these boats?
Alright, I have a serious question to ask.
What?
So, like, what if, like, a famous YouTuber does end up suing, like, a basic small town, small channel, like, for using either, like, their slogan or something, like, something really dumb, but, like, the YouTuber, like, fucking sues you for it and they send you a letter and shit, and then you, like, will you just be excited at the fact that that YouTuber that's suing you is one of your favorite YouTubers, and you just get excited that this person's just giving you attention, or do you, like...
I would kind of freak out a little bit. Like, I'd be excited, but at the same time, I'd be like, well, fuck. Like, I'm not trying to steal anybody's slogan. Like, I created this channel myself, and, well, if you want to get technical about it, I am ripping off a movie. I am ripping off The Big Lebowski.
I know, but I'm saying, like, if someone was intentionally trying to steal every, like, a popular YouTuber's, like, slogan and jokes, but, like, on purpose, like, knowing that, like, yeah. and not giving them credit for it. Or saying, hey, like, we got this from Game Grumps, or hey, we got this from Markiplier. Like
we always do that.
I know, but, like the person is actually doing it on purpose and not giving the actual person the credit. And then this person finds you because other people have shared it and shown it to the popular guys. And then they sue you. And then you're like, whoa, finally, they're finally giving me attention because I've been doing this my whole life just to get their attention. And now you're getting sued.
Yeah, right. It would suck. It really would.
Like, I would be excited that there's a famous person trying to contact me, but at the same time, I'd be kind of worried, too, because I'm like, well, damn.
Attack me, dude.
I don't wanna.
Fine, you're dead.
Eat your corn dogs.
What is this dude swimming over there for?
Everyone's glitching the fuck out in this game, like, seriously.
There's some weird shit going on.
Like, we got people who die, and the lion stopped roaring for some reason. And then they're freaking fucking over there. You just hear that? Oh, you put. See? Everyone's like little role thing is going copter cocking. Watch, you think he's gonna fucking.
Dude, I love these sleep darts. This is so. One soldier's in the water. Oh, cocksucker. And you're just standing there doing nothing, dude. Who noticed me?
He didn't even know his back was turned. He didn't notice you.
What is going on? Oh boy. What? just, you're just jumping off the safety of your boat.
Well, because they see you supposedly, and they're like, "Oh, we jump in the water. Oh, we're stupid. He's not. He's far away from us."
Okay. Caught him in the Achilles heel. Oh fuck me. There we go.
No,
you just die? Oh my god, dude.
He's jumping in the water constantly now for some reason.
Dead. Jesus Christ, you're annoying.
Just had like a tiny sliver.
Alright, this is gonna be tricky because there's a ton of guys.
What the hell?
What?
They're doing jumping jacks. Go back around. See? Watch. No, like there's a little. See? No, just there's two of them. Out of all of them, two of them are doing jumping jacks. Like, everything's just getting all glitchy. That's how you know you're closer to the end of the game, when everything starts to get glitchy.
Okay, that didn't work. Fuck. Just gonna jump over here. There's a guy.
In the water.
I'm gonna dive underwater and assassinate him.
Yeah. By the feet, they tickle him.
Oh, thank God, I can't see directly up by X-Towel.
Oh, yes, you can. It's just underwear there.
He's stuck between the boat and the ship. He is stuck between the boat and the ship.
He's an idiot.
He is stuck between the boat and the fucking ship.
That's how you know Bayek finds out that he's in a video game, because everyone's glitching out.
What is happening? Oh, what the fuck? Alright, this is going to be really tricky because there's a lot of soldiers on this boat right here. I mean, there's really a lot of them.
You got the two jumping jacks in the back there. Kill those first.
Shh, no, you did not see me. You not see me. What? Oh my god. Oh my god, you asshole!
I'm missing all my fucking shots. Who the what in the femus and the femur? What?
You wanna be famous? What?
I wanna be famous.
When I grow up, I wanna be famous. I wanna be the king. I wanna be in Egypt. When I grow up, I wanna see the world. Drive nice cars. I wanna have boobies. When I grow up, be on TV, sit on my feet, and reading magazines.
What?
Fresh and clean, watching my booty 24/7 and I'm clean. But be careful what you wish for, cause those farts won't get it.
Alright, now what do I do?
Touch the torch and burn everyone.
Climb up higher.
I'm a Bayek, I climb higher.
Okay, I wanted to... I want to get to the next platform, not climb all the way up.
Will you hurry up?
Ooh, arrows. Okay, so... I'm gonna switch to this. Dead. Hold still. Crap. Canis Kunis. Mila Kunis. What?
Unis Anis.
Oh, crap. Hi.
This is for Tahira.
Dude, I said that, like, at the perfect freaking time.
Oh, yeah, that was Rufio. That's it. You didn't have to kill everyone.
Didn't even have to kill all the soldiers. All right. This is for Tahira. Overpower attack. Dead.
Yeah, fuck
fucking
yeah.
Perfect, dude.
It just,
I
like,
swear to God, if you go all demon and go, the order is eternal.
Have you broken my plans? The hidden ones will never allow the order of ancients room to breathe. So it is true.
Why do you look like Ray Stevenson?
We thrive. Strange.
I don't feel like he's a very well-known actor.
No.
Peace. Order.
This guy looks like Ray Stevenson. I'll put up a picture for comparison.
I just like how the fact that he's in that towel outfit, it just suits him.
You cannot kill us.
Yes, I can, and I already did.
Caesar built a strong order before he was stabbed in the back by your cowardly wife.
Hey,
don't talk about my wife that way. She's less of a coward than I am.
I mean, in a way, I kind of am.
The hidden ones bury you. Anubis awaits.
No, I'm saying, like, that towel. The towel office suits him for this specific, specific scene because he's in the water and he's in a dream. It just looks like he's in a sauna.
Okay, why can't I fight? Oh.
Just get out of there. Don't even bother.
The greater good. Wait, what? What is... Ow! Ah! Cabroni!
Cabroni?
Fucking... I'm on fire again! Why? Why am I always on fire?
Just get out of there.
I'm gonna leave. Bye!
Come here, you coward. No, I already killed your leader.
Killed your leader. I'm out. Bye.
I'm the leader here now.
Bye. Bye, have a beautiful time.
Bye, have a beautiful time.
Okay,
damn, he's all bloody and burnt.
The greater
and
good.
And I love how his legs look like chocolate, like most shiny chocolate. Chocolate.
Oh my god.
Oh, chocolate. Oh, chocolate.
Stop it, what are you doing?
Chocolate.
I want chocolate, it makes me horny. Horny honey makes me horny.
I am a horny honey.
You horny honey.
I am a horny honey. That's what that should be my new username. My name is Horny Honey.
Horny honey.
This is
You're gonna attract all the wrong attention.
I know, it's like and this is I'm dude and this is Horny Honey. And we'll be back. And now I'm doing games. Don't fuck my wife.
And don't be fucking my wife while you're gone.
Don't get me started.
Don't even get me started fucking my wife.
Look at my
we got that from Game Grumps. We even made the whole bit up about freaking. Ow! Dude! Ah! Ah! I'm crushed between a boat and rocks, and it's the only thing keeping me alive! Motherfucker! I know I'm a Magi, but you're gonna fucking die for that. How fucking dare you! I may be a Magi, but that dude freaking ran straight into me and crushed me between his boat and the shoreline.
Touched your butt,
didn't he? Oh my god!
And he touched your butt, like I told you, like I warned you. Every woman's gonna touch that butt.
It wasn't a woman! He was just a regular fucking guy on a boat and he just.
Oh, she was facing the other way. I thought she looked dead for a second. All I saw was her body like this.
I have killed the men we set
and
out to kill again.
Again. Are you turned on? Let's fuck real quick. Did you kill Rufio? Yes. How did you kill him? At first. Oh yeah!
There's a more immediate problem.
I'm pregnant again.
Camelot. Who?
The people look you again. The last time we fucked, you remember? That was 40 years ago. You're pregnant for 4 years? Yes. Yes.
He fights for the people.
And I have the body of a...
You and I just witnessed a massacre. Have spoken to the villagers. There have been many such massacres.
I love her outfit.
I know. I feel like I would cosplay that. I would just have to kind of make the skirt a little bit more high-rise to cover up the belly a little bit, just to show this part, and not like the actual belly stuff. But I feel like I could pull it off.
Great.
You think I could pull it off? I think I could pull it off. Because I'm too sexy for my clothes, too sexy for my skirt, so sexy it hurts.
Many villagers are slaughtered in the fight.
So great. I knew there was something wrong with Camelot. I knew that him freaking acting stupid and me having to, like, escort his ass through that cave, I knew there was going to be something bad, and now I got to kill him because he's being a bad dude, he's not upholding the ideals, and I got to kill him.
So, yeah, it's like you can't even trust anyone anymore. To recruit more rebels. It's like they used to be old friends and old comrades and stuff, but it's like now it's like you can't even trust them.
He's building a rebellion at a terrible price. He's gotta go.
He's a friend.
He may seem that way to you.
Recall that Cleopatra was more than a friend. Yet I trusted her to.
What, you're saying you're a lesbian in another life?
You got. Don't make the same mistake again by trusting someone that you think is your friend and they end up betraying you.
Well, yeah, it's happened throughout the whole game.
It happened throughout the whole game. It happened with Cleopatra. Well, that it happened with your Greek and Roman friends.
Well, yeah, all of his friends were happened to be the people that we were looking for.
Yeah, exactly. Like all the people that he supposedly knew
years ago. And it's like, it might have been, like I said, they might have been a brotherhood and friends years ago, but now everyone is like, you can't even trust your...
Seriously, friend. Like, trust no one. And it's happened throughout the entire franchise. It happened in the first game.
Oh my god, they're riding the same horse.
It happened in the first Assassin's Creed game with Altair and Al-Mualim, the leader of the Brotherhood of Assassins. No, it was a Middle Eastern... It was a... No, you don't. I killed you. My god, Willy! Learn when to fuck off!
Just double penetrated. Poor horsey.
You fucker's quite done. Oh my god. Jesus. No, seriously, it happened in the first game where it's like Al-Mualim's ideals aligned more so with the Templars, and he ended up betraying, like, the leader of that Brotherhood of Assassins ended up betraying the entire order.
Yeah.
And Altair in the end had to fight him and kill him. He was the final boss fight.
Tell me of your life in Rome.
I played that game. It was great. Deceit and corruption. It was a different time for Assassin's Creed. I'm not gonna say that.
He's legit asking her.
I expected you to talk about the wine.
He's literally trying to. You should come visit. He's asking to make sure she's not fucking a dude. That's why he's really asking. He's
like, asking for what?
He's like, oh, so what is your life now in Rome? And he's just expecting her to say, like, oh, I've met a new guy and I'm fucking a new guy.
Right, yeah.
And that's why he's asking her deep down. He's just like, is she fucking anyone else?
Cannot challenge him in front of them.
Explore the rebel camp. Hi.
Hi, rebel? Yes, okay.
Five lookouts. The supply lines have to the five lookouts in the mountains must be secure. The Romans have been more aggressive as of late. What's over here? Young, aren't you? Come here, place. You're younger than I am, dude.
I have no reason to laugh.
Sure. Sorry. We're running into people.
To honor my father, killed by the Romans.
Okay, where's the next thingy? Where's the next exploration thingy? Why no exploration thingy? I don't see any other exploration thingies. Explore the rebel camp for Gamelot's whereabouts. Okay, what am I looking for?
You need to probably talk to people.
Oh, there's someone up here. Hi.
Neb, where's your leader?
Take me to your leader.
Okay.
A hunt near the oasis, eh? Carbon crystals I don't need anymore, eh?
He's in the oasis, apparently, so we gotta talk to
He's
him
now. He's in the oasis. That's a great big world song.
Yeah.
I will go speak to Camelot. You stay here. Keep the rebels away.
Fight well.
I really wish I could have played as Aya a little bit more. She's becoming a pretty interesting character. What? What? What are you laughing at?
I'm laughing at you.
She's becoming a pretty interesting character. Look at all that power.
Yeah, that's what I'm expecting.
No, that's not what I'm saying. I'm not sexualizing her at all. Not even low key. Dead serious. Like she ended. I feel like she ended up becoming like the underdog favorite of this game just because her character arc was a bit more interesting than Bayek's. It really was.
Well, then she's killed more people than Bayek, to be honest.
Right? Well, I mean, maybe. I feel like they both killed pretty much the same amount of people.
Well, even in the beginning when we started, she killed like
half of the guys I thought I was supposed to kill, and yeah. It's like, dude, you're stealing my thunder.
Yeah.
Come on, man.
She was assassin longer than you've Come been on, in magic.
They both were. I didn't realize that they were had both taken that path.
Oh, no, yeah.
At the time.
They just fell in love and had a kid, so they took a break. His
towel is drenched. What is this about? Oh, I won't take off my top towel for you, big boy.
I have exposed the vile cruelty of the Romans. Those martyrs have inspired countless warriors to continue the fight.
Martyrs?
We're not martyrs, dude.
In light of freedom for all.
The lives of a few villagers. They had no choice in the matter.
Bayek, don't be absurd. We fight on the same side.
No, you don't.
No, you don't. Not with the tactics you use, brother. Brother.
Brother.
Your reign ends here, brother. I'm gonna kick your ass. Let this be the end of it.
Gamelot and Camelot.
You will be the ultimate.
Gamelot, your quest for Camelot ends here.
Your blows will glance off this shield.
Your nose will bounce off this ship.
What? Ah, you knocked me off!
It's okay, you're in a towel.
It's over, Bayek. I have the high ground.
Oh, don't you fucking quote Obi-Wan at me!
Hey, what?
Did you hear him? He's like, it's over, Bayek! I have the high ground!
Yeah.
Ow!
You'll sit on your dick.
Yeah, come down here,
oh,
big boy.
Where did the fire go? How did you put out that fire just walking down the stairs? Knock him in the water too, since he knocked you over, so you can shoot him.
Oh crap! He oh. Ow! 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 I parried that. I parried it. Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Let me. Let me. Just
push
let
him
me.
In the water. Push him in the water.
You cannot harm me now.
I keep parrying at the wrong fucking time! My god! How does he dodge that?
A little bit more, come on. A little bit more, come on, there you go.
You're done, brother!
Ex-brother.
Ex-brother-in-law.
What?
What? Who are you?
Yeah, we killed Gamelot.
Okay, killed Gamelot.
We killed a Camelot.
Ah, jeez.
There is freedom. There is the life of innocence. Both must be balanced on
this edge. Love how, like... He picks and chooses when he takes his towel off.
Yes, Anubis.
Your heart beat too strongly in favor of its cause. The innocent must always be protected.
As much as possible. Innocents still die no matter what you do.
Shone like sun in my eyes, blinding me. You have done right by me. I accept this death.
Good wow, job. Very cathartic. Finally, it's like awkward, like profound understanding moment with somebody that he's had to kill.
What?
And the person has accepted it. You know, that's rare.
Yeah. Well, he knows he was doing wrong. Like, he was trying to do the right thing, but the wrong tactic. The wrong reason.
Well, and it's like these guys they're just starting out their assassin bureau, so they're like kind of making this stuff up as they go.
Last until the end of time.
That's really cool. So like, haha, new rule. No harming the innocent. Didn't think we'd have to write that one down, but we did. Seriously. Huh.
The greatest of leaders.
Haganu.
Haggis.
Hagga.
His name is Haggis.
Hagalaga.
His name is Hagler.
And the warriors of the Sinai. He could kill a million tyrants with one breath. A divine arrow
It's freaking Stevie Wonder looking heaven.
The great Gamelot.
I'm an effer.
Just no longer.
The blind poet with a lute. Was it very superstitious how that story ended? Haganu. So what becomes of you two now?
We kill their dreams.
Nah.
Let them have their heroes. For now, the hidden ones are forgotten. This is to our favor.
Mm-hmm.
Gamelot's death serves a higher cause.
No more senseless martyrs.
Nope. Can you two just, like, stick together? Like, I love the two of you.
Have we done good?
No, she's missing her ring finger, too.
Well, yeah, because she had to. They all did. They all sacrificed their ring finger.
No smooch of victory.
Smooch of victory.
No, side boob of honor.
Side boob.
No booty of wonder. No. No sex.
No
of
booty
winning.
Of heroism.
Booty of
no
heroism.
Ass clap of
victory.
Victory. Yeah.
No sex of killing all the wrong people.
Those who have taken our oath.
Yes. Didn't think we'd have to write that one down, but again, people are stupid.
The hidden ones will pass on to Petra. Towards Judea and forever. The creed must live beyond anyone.
No one shall be bigger than the greater group. When I return to Rome, I will not speak of heroes. I will speak of discipline and perseverance.
Just standing there in a fucking towel. I can't take it seriously.
Our will never
it's my fault.
And our blades shall never tire.
Amen. Wait, that's the wrong religion.
They just kill you on the spot.
Ah, shit! Ayak, you just, sexy, like, bro.
Can you guys just kiss one last time?
One last kiss for good luck, please. There please. Please. Fuck off with that handshake and bullshit.
Oh, they love each other.
Come on. So. Yeah. Just kiss, please. I hate I stop it. Stop living in perpetual agony of not being able to be together. Just fucking be together. You're killing me. You guys are really killing me.
They just did the typical brotherhood shake. Like, it's like when you have a broken up couple that actually still love each other. They just over a dumb reason that they just couldn't be together for some reason. And it's like they meet up again. Instead of trying to kiss, they just do the whole, like, high five. And it's all awkward.
If Senu flew past him and it wafts a breeze back towards his towel and it just blows it off.
And then the fucking Almunette just, like, smells his scent. Just, oh, wait. Someone's ready.
Wow, so that was the hidden ones.
Yay, the greater good. 15,000 XP. Extra so. Penis.
Extra penis?
That's what I call XP now.
Oh my god. That was a great... Ooh, bow of Ra. Nice.
You're hanging with the big boys now.
That was a pretty solid DLC. Story, yeah. Pretty solid DLC. And it kind of expanded upon their new upstarted Brotherhood of Assassins a little bit more. And so I like that. And it reunited Aya and Bayek for a little bit. It's pretty cool.
It sucks that you can tell their love still.
I know. It really is heartbreaking. It's very heartbreaking. But I'm just going to keep Bayek in this same outfit for the next DLC. there's part of me that wants to now. It was like when I put helium mode on for my Uncharted 4 Let's Play. But that was pretty cool. So in the next episode of Assassin's Creed Origins, we'll start the Curse of the Pharaohs DLC. Hopefully, that shouldn't take too long to get through either. As far as content goes for this channel, this Let's Play will now have been going on for for a few months. By the time we finished uploading all this stuff, and it's just because I really don't have the time to be doing daily uploads like I used to in the past anymore, so. But But it is what it is, and we'll get through as much content as we can as quickly as we can. I can't wait to start AC Odyssey. So, in the meantime, my name is I'm the Dude 5.
This is Reaper Goddess.
We are I'm the Dude Games. Please subscribe, click that bell icon to receive all notifications.
Oh, yeah.
Like the video, comment what your favorite part was. Follow me on Twitter, link in the description below. Stay classy. We'll see you all out there in the next episode.
Bye!